Hey, welcome back again to Auto Transport Intel. My name is Jay. Welcome back to Tuesday Nights Live on Auto Transport Intel. And it's 8 o'clock, so welcome back. I appreciate you guys coming back every week, coming back for more. Welcome back to the show, Mike. It's been good talking to you, been good, you know, bringing you up to speed on car hauling dispatching. So I'm enjoying it, and it's neat to see some of the knowledge that I pass on actually happening. It's awesome. Patrick, welcome back to the show, man. All right, I'm good. It's Tuesday night, and I've been dispatching all day, and so I'm glad to be back to my roots, which is the show, sharing knowledge with you, having some fun also. So I'm good, man. Thank you. I'm over here. I'm looking at my, I've got my, my live chat screen. So welcome back, Davison. And good to hear that you're, you know, doing well and picking up steam. So, I mean, I couldn't be more blessed than being able to, you know, expand the core. This is my core. You guys are part of my core. Dave Williams, man. All right. Awesome. So we got a new video coming out with me and Dave. Well, Dave is, you know, hauling cars, and I'm recording it and editing it, and man, that video is going to be great. Hopefully in the next week. So look for that. Man, I'm really excited. Jesse, welcome back to the show, man. Awesome. Thanks for coming back. I really appreciate it. With the one and only is back. All right, welcome back. Good to see you, man. You're part of my core. Alex, you're part of my core. Welcome back to the show. Awesome, man. And if Dave was any better, he'd be twins. That is a fact. That is a fact, man. Dave is good to go. We are the crew. It is. It's cool, man. And it's growing. The channel's growing, and I've been having some great conversations with folks, and I can't believe the momentum just keeps building. So I'm really excited to see where this is. Show number 28. So this show is just over the 6-month mark of every Tuesday night at 8 o'clock. The shows are running for about 90 minutes to 2 hours now, so try and keep it at 90 minutes. That's a long show. So if you're bored, go ahead and you can skip ahead to the 20-minute mark, where we're going to get through the Facebook news and get into the interview. Now, tonight we're going to do DispatchMonkey.com feedback. So this is the second DispatchMonkey.com show in a row, and I don't think I've done that before. But I like to break rules and mix it up, right? Isn't that what car hauling is all about? So, when I say break rules, I mean, I don't have a specific formula for this show. And I don't know where the ecosystem is going to take me next. We do have a Dispatcher Training Part 3 show coming up in the near future. We're going to do, top 5 reasons that car haulers go out of business. I think we're doing that next week. That's going to be good. Oh, also, there's a dealer that I met. I want to have him on the show and talk about car buying. So, man, I mean, it's awesome. CarShipIO, Stan, welcome back to the show, man. It's good to have you back. I was reminiscing, and we had a really good show. I was just under 1,000 subscribers when you and I had a great show. I think that was mid-January. So, it's great to have you in the core, man. You're part of the core. So D Newsom, new to the show. Welcome to the show, D. I hope you like it. I really do. And I also, I feel bad. Samuel Mayfield was in the chat a week ago, and I didn't notice, and I didn't say hello, and I felt really bad. So if I miss you in the live chat, I'm sorry, because I want to say hello to everybody. And it's not that big of a show yet, so I should be able to at least say hello to everyone. It's like being at a small party and you don't say hello to one person. It's like, what's up with that? Self-made, welcome back to the show, man. I appreciate it. I've seen you in here many times. So, all right, we are at 8:06, so I got 14 minutes to do Facebook news. So let's jump into it. Now, I keep saying Facebook news, but it's really industry news, because it's not just Facebook, it's mostly Facebook. And I also want to thank Aaron Kahn for, I haven't talked with him, but I'm using his truck pictures here. So hopefully, you know, if you see him, thank him for me, will you? I would appreciate that. All right, let's go into it. Where's my first image at? Where is my first image? Okay. Oh, yeah, so I'm starting off with this. Isn't that a nice looking car on a car hauler? That's just a beautiful shot. I like the car. I like the shot. I'm thinking, you know, beautiful weather somewhere in the south. I don't know. It makes me think of Florida or the Carolinas. Man, that's awesome. It's probably, well, there's a little water in the background and a camper. It's probably near Kissimmee, which is Orlando. I don't know. I'm guessing. Big Papa's back. Welcome back to the show, Big Papa. Really appreciate it. Starting out, been gone for 2 weeks. Okay, D, you're going to learn a lot. And feel free to chat with other car haulers in here. There's a lot of, we've talked about this, there's a lot of negativity out there, you know? But hopefully not so much at Auto Transport Intel. I'm trying to keep it positive. But if you get some negativity, hey, it's car hauling, man. Hashtag. This is car hauling. So, yeah. All right, so keep doing that. All right, let's go to the next one. Wow, I've seen it all. Oh, you haven't seen anything yet. Watch some of these next slides. I feel like I should be at a slide projector hitting that old thing. Nobody has those anymore. Okay, here we go. Even if it don't fit, it ships. That is a lawnmower. I know you can tell what it is, but I know it's... Isn't it amazing? That is amazing. Show that to the DOT when you're standing there in Iowa and the guy's... All right. Have you seen the video? Man. If you want to see some interesting stuff, go to the Auto Transport Intel Facebook page. And I try and put, you know, call attention to some interesting videos, whether it's DOT officers or interesting news articles. Yeah, check that out. Some interesting stuff up there. I'm just going to leave this here. So, man, there's been so many wrecks again lately. Now, this is clearly... I mean, you know, come on, man. Hire a professional. I mean, the rates aren't that high, are they? Crying out loud. Needs more gold. Yeah, that's a good one, man. That's true. Needs more gold. Let us kneel and pray that this guy can make it through the states of Iowa and Missouri on his way to his destination. They really enjoy seeing those flippers being used. Yeah. Yeah, wish we could be on the fly, a fly on the wall for that one. Be on the fly on the wall. Sounds like a Led Zeppelin album. Instant convertible. We see that all the time. Man, look at that. There's the hood. Yeah. Hey, hold on a second. Just, you know, get a scissors and cut off the... Here's your hood. Okay, so that's good. Your hood, at least your hood is here. All right. Oops. Yeah. Yeah. Would like to see more of that one. So, it's not going to be good. That's not going to be good. You're not going to get a whole lot of farming done right now. That is interesting, man. What, slammed on the brakes? Goom! Right in there. Yeah, dude. Hey, Rithy Mac, see? All right, he's back, man. The crew, the boys are back in town. And the girls. The girls are welcome. Come on now. Tractor through the back window. It's going to be in the front seat soon. You'll be doing farming in the front seat. That one sucks, too. You hate to see that. Did he just take the corner too sharp? Was he trying to turn around? Why did that happen? Doesn't seem like that needed to happen. Who? Okay, all right, so those are the wrecks. All right, now we're going to go into, gosh darn it, I'm going to bore you guys with some more ELD. Who has the best ELD service out there in your opinion? Boy, what happened to the color on the screen? Is that because of the... I think it's because of the purple of the monitor. All right, let's get off this screen. So we're talking about ELD. People are talking about ELD. That's my whole point. We're still trying to figure out what to do. Who did y'all pick for your ELDs and how's it going so far? Now, someone recently asked me. I said keep trucking. I mean, I don't know. I don't know what to say. Go to eldratings.com, I guess. And I don't know, man. Just spin the wheel, dude. And that's why I just noticed there's another ELD on the market, like Easy Logs. I don't know, man. Easy Peasy Logs. me trying to jump through all the hoops of trucking regulations. That's pretty funny. Put that on your t-shirt. That's a good one, man. That's just a cool image. How did that happen? Who's going to help him out? Caution, driver may be tired. Driver using an ELD. Pass with care. Yeah. ELD, dude. See? You see? I get upset. I just need to calm down a little, man. You just need to get your super safe, super Kool-Aid. It's green. At least it's safe. Where are we going now? How safe is this? I stopped to ask if he was okay, and he said he's out of hours. Yep. Pretty much sums it up. Yep. I'm out of hours. I got 30 minutes to think about how great life is. I know, I've always had that rule, but now I really got to do it, you know. What are some dumb rules that office workers have? You know, office workers have dumb rules too. Do they follow them? No. Come on. Stop with the you should have thought of that and all the law breaks. Shit, stop with all that. Everybody breaks all kinds of little laws all day long. Stop. Crying out loud. People cross the state line to buy alcohol. Well, you should have thought of that. Going to jail. Stupid. Getting inspected on the cheese. Jay, calm down. Any of the ELD providers out of biz yet? No kidding, man. Can we get a list of ELD providers out of business? That'd be cool. That'd be a good show. No, it wouldn't. Nobody would watch that. Anyone have this happen yet? This looks like an Etch-a-Sketch. Like, how do you even go backwards? No, we didn't go backwards. I don't know. I have no idea. But I know this is pretty funny. There's a red exclamation mark. Try and explain that to the DOT. That'll be a good time. That's what they call a good time. That's what it should say below. Good time. All right. Oh, man. Now, this one, dude. So, whoever posted this, I guess has suggested, well, I mean, they're in the truck, and it does look like the color of that truck of the company that I guess is now doing this. Dude, can you see this? Not good, man. Not good. This is worse than drone delivery. There's a camera in your rear view mirror, dude. That blows, dude. I mean, I know the technology exists. I know. I get that. You should have thought of that. But come on. Really? Anyways, I'm just going to leave that there, as they say. It's not cool, man. Do we need cameras in the car? Oh, here we go. See, because what if the guy that put the camera in the car is this guy? Dear car hauler, this truck stop is for loaded trucks only, not trucks that just drive around looking cool, costing their company money. You should be ashamed of yourself. You also parked 0.2 inches off center. Are you serious? What is wrong with you? I'm reporting you to Super Trucker Police because of your sheer negligence. I almost messed myself going to get more corn dogs. Are you serious? Yours truly, the angry trucker. I don't get it, man. Really? This doesn't even make sense. That can't be real. You need to get an ELD. You need to go to bed. Have you guys seen that? You need to go to bed. I think that's hilarious. All right. The Tim Hawkins Handbook for Alternative Cuss Words. And you even got categories. Oh, shoot. That's great. Great googly moogly. Great Caesar's Ghost. Oh, this is like Ron Burgundy right here. Heavens to Betsy. This is a great list. Rassa, Frassa, Rassa, Frassa. Jumpin' Jehoshaphat. I like this. Need to keep this handy. Put this next to my Alpha Tango Whiskey Foxtrot list of military, what do you call those? Oh, you hit the like button. Thank you, Patrick. If you haven't hit the like button yet, please do hit the like button. I really like it when you hit the like button. Thank you so much. I really appreciate that. It does help my YouTube rankings, and it makes me feel warm and fuzzy. So that's pretty cool. Better than ELD. Oh, here we go. Roberto Blake. Yeah, I'm going to get some notifications there. This is, you know, godliness is not here, actually. I mean, maybe. Okay. Come on. I think now the tradition is to put in at least one slide that is just, you know, terrible. How people use the gas station bathrooms. Seems like it, right? Everybody knows. Everybody's thinking they've seen this dude's work. Probably a broker. Okay, that's not fair. All right, ruthless used car dealer. Want to get back on your feet? Missed two car payments. That's pretty funny, man. That's what they call good marketing. So, yeah, I think the note there was, not sure how this happened. That is one heck of a, I mean, it seems like vandalism, but I don't know. Can that happen while you're driving? Nothing like $748 fill up. I think I have enough points for a free coffee now. You guys do this all day long, man. It's crazy. That's what it costs to put gas in a boat, I'm pretty sure. Maybe more. This is kind of like, unfortunately, this is kind of what it's like to get into car hauling at first, you know? To get the insurance, to get the tractor, to get the trailer, to get the, you know, you're going to have your maintenance fund. You got to buy fuel. You got to buy equipment, straps. I mean, my goodness. You got to get all your licensing. You got to satisfy all of the requirements to pass your first audit. Man, and on, you got to hire a dispatcher, stinking dispatchers. Anybody know a good shop in Jersey for hydraulic repair? I don't know. Is getting a car puller really worth it? Never used one before. I hear the answer to that is yes. And there are car pulling companies now. I hope to have a car pulling company interview in the future too. That'd be cool. All right. And by the way, this show is also for if you are going to ship a car, I encourage you to watch this show. You're going to learn about what car hauling is all about. And, you know, there is a real reason why car haulers charge what they charge. This is an expensive industry. It's a difficult industry. It's an unpredictable industry. And it seems like every day somebody else is trying to reach in the car hauler's wallet. So, by the way, what I just said has nothing to do with how good Little Cottrell LLC is at welding. Apparently, that's a good welder. So, thanks a lot, Jay. You ruined my welding day. Okay, so they have car hauler stuff here. Sacramento 49er Travel Plaza. That's pretty cool. You know, you walk around the truck stop, look at the DVDs, check out the toy car haulers. What do we got here? Intestinal yoga. Intestinal yoga. Okay. And there's a flatbed going in the parking garage. That's pretty good. I see shorter, what do you call those? Where your smoke comes out the top? I see them getting shorter. That's what I'm trying to say. I see the cement, yeah, whatever. Okay. Well done. Well done there, Jay. Please slow down. Okay, men working. That's right. This is my last slide of industry news because we are men working. So let's help each other out, slow down a little bit. You know, you always see people speeding through the construction zones. I don't have to tell you guys that. But that is a transition slide into, it's 8:21. Before we do that, I want to do this. I want to read this. Now, if you don't know, there were some folks meeting with the FMCSA. from ELD or me, or I think it was from Trucker Nation. Anyways, here we go. I haven't read this yet, but I'm pretty sure it's a regular message to the FMCSA, and that is that this isn't about safety. Doesn't feel that way. It feels like this is about greed and the large corporations. We're talking about ELDs. We're talking about new DOT reg technology coming down on truckers. I mean, on my Facebook page, there's a video of a guy in I think it's Milwaukee, talking about how bad truckers are. It's amazing. There's a thing about talking about drones for ELDs now. They want to regulate and nickel and dime the little man to death. Small fleets don't hire newbies. Our drivers must have 3 hours clean, yet large corporations can seat a CDL permit holder behind the wheel and co-pilot trainer with less than a year experience. Wow. They are self-insured, they are not impacted by rate increases, and many of their incidents are not reported, so their safety score is not impacted. It's believable. The large companies receive more benefits, such as government funding and bulk purchases, while little guys may receive 10 cents off at the pump. The mega carriers are receiving upwards of 24 to 30 cents off on the back end in rebates. The ELD is filled with technical issues, and the only purpose it serves is to make money for someone else. It does the exact thing as a paper log. Just because drivers prefer paper doesn't mean they are cheating. Their fuel fleet card, their pre-pass, toll charges, shippers and receivers are all timestamped and can easily be compared against a paper log. A paper log for 30 days cost me $1.50, whereas an ELD is $50 plus the cost of the device and tablet. Now, multiply that by 6 trucks. Hours of service is where the focus needs to be. Let drivers make the determination of fatigue and give them the power to get off the road during congested periods. Start monitoring shippers and receivers. They are the factor behind the inability to plan stop going after us small people and claim that it's about safety. You want to check my trucks for issue, that's fine. You want to test my drivers for drug and alcohol, I'm good with that too. As a manager, I use a tracking device. I can see in real time every ounce of my driver's day, from speed, in and out times at facilities, breaks when they occur, and how often. Let us manage our own fleets. Every single device out there is fully editable in some degree. Why else would large carriers go out and purchase large amounts of trucks and put AOBRDs in them? Totally. Because the devices are 100% editable and grandfathered in. Let's go back to safety at one time. I was leased onto a company, TVM, minority attended the annual safety meeting, and was told that in their point system, before any real discipline action would be placed upon a driver, their points would have to be in upwards of 70 plus. These points were reflective of log violations, inspections, driving history, and so forth. They actually said a driver could have 3 speeds and an at-fault accident and still be considered safe. Does that equal safe? Not in my opinion. I've turned down 6 applications in the past 2 weeks because of driving habits. This is what safety is about. And I guarantee somebody watching right now knows exactly how she feels. Could be a lot of people. Could be everybody. Because frankly, what we're seeing is, I mean, we understand the need for technology. And actually, tonight is about technology that helps car haulers. But why does it seem like there is plenty of opposition technology which doesn't help car haulers, which doesn't help truckers, which doesn't really help the transportation working side? It helps the managers and those that are trying to make an extra buck. So, I hate ELD. Oh, man, I do. Now, I realize I should hate HOS, hours of service, or something. I don't know what I should hate. I should hate something else. Maybe I should just hate myself. But the fact is, I know what I'm seeing, and we keep talking about it, is it's not ready. Okay? Something. It's half-baked. Okay, here we go. Oh, yeah, man. I got my Kool-Aid. I feel so much better. I'm ready to do an awesome interview, because we're going to talk to Zimboy. at dispatchmonkey.com. So let's go ahead and give him a call. Now, he's only on the phone. That's an image of him. We talked earlier again today. And the point is, the goal tonight is to, hey, Alexander, all right, welcome back to the show. The goal tonight is to, this is part two of Dispatch Monkey. Dispatchmonkey.com wants your feedback. We've got some. We're going to get some more tonight. And we're also going to talk about some of the questions that were raised earlier. Two main questions: price, and does it really work? We're going to talk about those things. So let's do this. Yeah. Can you see that? Oh, yeah. Okay. Let's get this party started. And we're dialing. Okay, cool. I need some more Kool-Aid. Oh, that's pretty good. Hello. Are you listening to the show?
Yep. I am, Jay.
All right. Hey, welcome to the show, Zim Boy. It's Tuesday. Hey. It's Tuesday night, dude.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Jay, for having me on the show tonight.
Man, absolutely. It's my pleasure, and I'm excited to get back into the benefits of dispatchmonkey.com. You know that as a dispatcher, pretty much right away when you showed me this tool, I believe that I see the benefits. And I think I made the mistake a week ago, because I was a new user, I made the mistake of not properly showing that this tool does not require you to do a bunch of deadheading. It really finds best paying routes faster than you could do it manually. And the routes it spits out are actually good routes, where these are the types of routes you would actually pick for your driver.
Exactly.
So I made that mistake. That's on me, right? So we're gonna clear that up tonight. And you're gonna help me do that, right?
Yes, Jay. I'll do that tonight.
Uh-huh. All right. I appreciate that. Okay, so in the chat, we also have Dispatch Monkey Inc. in the chat. All right. And let's see. We have RSW Northwest. Do you have to use Central Dispatch to get loads, then input into Dispatch Monkey? Or can Dispatch Monkey be your one-stop shop, so to speak? So, you want to answer that question? Do you see that question in the live chat, Zimboy?
Oh, okay. Yeah, like I say, Jay, you know, tonight is going to be really just chatting with audiences and stuff, and really just trying to hear from them. I'm just following here. The engineer is actually also going to be answering some questions here.
Cool.
So, yeah, so we, it's going to be just logged in here within about 15 minutes and answering all the questions. So it's going to be an exciting night.
It is exciting. So let's do this. For anybody, if this is your first time joining us tonight and you haven't seen dispatchmonkey.com, let's take a look at it. So basically what we're talking about is, let me go to my main screen here. And I'm going to go ahead and I'll put, since I'm running the show here, let's do this. Let's minimize me. All right. So we are, right now I'm on my computer. I'm on dispatchmonkey.com. Go to dispatchmonkey.com, right? Now listen, and again, I want to make this clear. I met Zimboy, 3 weeks ago? You contacted me through the show? And
yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I mean, so a month ago, we didn't even know each other. And I am, since I basically love to talk about anything car hauling, whether it's technology, equipment, there's brokers and customers, I'm all over the place with what I talk about. But I have talked about car hauling technology before. I'm going to talk about it again. And you have presented me with some pretty interesting car hauling technology here. So that's why we're talking about Dispatch Monkey tonight. So we're going to go to dispatchmonkey.com. Now, if you're a car hauler or a dispatcher, this is a website for you, right? This isn't necessarily for brokers. This is for car haulers and dispatchers. If you're trying to put a route or a load together, this is for you, okay? Something weird going on with my camera. I don't know what's going on with the lighting there, so I'm not going to worry about it. These things happen. You got to roll with it, right? So you go to dispatchmonkey.com. Now, RSW Northwest has asked a integral question. Does dispatchmonkey.com have loads, like a load board, or like a load board, or like a board, like a load board, or do you need to get loads from a load board, copy and paste, and throw it into DispatchMonkey? The answer is you do need to copy from a load board and pop it into DispatchMonkey. Am I right about that?
Yes, you're correct, Jay.
Okay. So I'm gonna do a login. It is free. All right. This is now free. So clearing up number one, there were pricing questions. We were doing a special that was a week ago, and in 1 week you've already updated it. This is now free. Is that right?
Yes. This is now a free tool to all car haulers to use and take advantage of and enjoy it.
That's awesome, man. Okay, so now it's free. Just log in anytime, and I'm going to say this to you right now. If you aren't logging in to dispatchmonkey.com and you're looking for loads, I don't know why you're not logging in. I honestly don't. I've been dispatching for years, and I can already tell you in the past 3 weeks that I've seen this thing, it works. So we're going to clear up number two about deadheading miles and routes that don't make sense. Not true. We're going to show you tonight that it actually, DispatchMonkey spits out routes. You can throw in several hundred search results, and in less than 5 seconds, it's going to suggest multiple routes that not only have the highest paying loads, but actually suggest routes that you could actually just go ahead and book, and there's your load. Now, one might say, well, does this replace dispatchers? No. Because how are you going to book those loads? You got to make phone calls. Who's going to make sure those cars are ready? Dispatchers. Who's going to talk to people and get the gate passes and buyer number and all the detective work on the dispatch that wasn't there, that for some reason didn't get on the dispatch, and now you have this partially filled out dispatch? You still need dispatchers. I believe that. I totally do. But this tool speeds up the process. That's what technology does. I made the analogy a week ago that obviously at some point in time, there was somebody that used a broom to clean up the warehouse. And one day somebody handed him a vacuum. Did he keep using the broom or did he try the vacuum? He tried the vacuum and he loved it. He was done a lot faster. Did he lose his job? No, he didn't. But he does it with a vacuum now. There's no need to do it with a broom if you have a vacuum. All right. Point made, I hope. All right, so I'm going to log in, which is easy. I like how simple your software is to use. I signed up, I clicked join here, put in my name, put in my email address, created a password, and I'm logging in. It's easy. It's really easy. So here we go. I'm logging in, and now I'm at my front page, right? This is now, it's ready for me to do something. It's ready for me to copy and paste search results from a load board into the paste search results here box, right? And I'm doing the talking, but as we talked about, I mean, this is, I'm the one on camera kind of leading the charge. You're here to help make sure that I do that properly. It's hard for me to hand it over to you because we can't see each other. It's just the format of the show. So, you know, I got the torch. It's Raiders of the Lost Ark. I'm leading the way through the cave, and you're right there next to me, right, Zimboy? You're next to me?
Yes, I'm right here, Jake.
All right, let's go through the cave together, right?
Okay. Yeah.
You can see this. Yeah. Oh, that's right. Oh, we made the analogy earlier that this is like Back to the Future, and Zimboy is Doc Brown, and I guess that makes me Michael J. Fox. Okay, so are you ready to get in the DeLorean? Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's get in the DeLorean. Here we go. All right, so So, all right, we're going to search for loads. So first, you create drivers. I think that's the thing you do first. So like, and it's super easy. I'm going to add a new driver. I'm going to name my driver John, okay? And I'm going to put my phone number, and I'm going to put my email address, and I'm just going to put his total capacity. I'm going to say 4, okay? So John is a 4 car, and the only reason I put the email address is, I'm going to show you something cool because I can share my route with the driver immediately. Okay, we got some questions coming in. Before I go to questions, and what we'll do is we'll back up. You need central dispatch, dispatch monkey. That is true. Would you agree with that? We're not pulling any punches. We agreed we're gonna address every elephant that comes in the chat room. We said this, right?
Yeah.
You're with me. Yeah. Okay. So you need central dispatch to use dispatch monkey. True or false?
True.
Yeah,
you need a load board like central dispatch. Yeah.
Okay. Awesome, man. I like it. So we've addressed that. I try monkey dispatch, but it looks like it still needs some work. Okay. Fair enough. Alexander, please elaborate on that. You can either do that in the chat line, or if you're watching and this is no longer a live stream, leave the comments below this video. No joke, Zimboy wants to hear your criticisms because he literally wants to make the tool that you want to have. True?
Exactly.
Because getting back to the history, listen, I've been a dispatcher for years. You have been a dispatcher for years and a car hauler, correct?
Exactly, huh?
All right, so you know exactly how it feels to look for loads day after day. I mean, you could probably... Do you dream about booking loads? I'll bet... What's the answer to that? Have you dreamt about booking loads? I have.
Yep.
I have... I have
24/7, yeah.
No, but no joke. I still dream about booking loads. That's how many loads I book. That's how many loads I search. It drives me crazy when I wake up and I was dispatching cars in my sleep, and now I got to get up and guess what I'm doing? Dispatching cars. So, I mean,
exactly.
Right? Okay, so we know what it means to look on the load board, and that's why we're here talking about this. Okay. Yes, you have to have central dispatch, how many times do you use central dispatch to look for loads? Give it a percentage. I'm gonna say 90 plus. 90% of the loads I book on central dispatch. True?
Very true.
Okay, so I mean, we are not fooling around. We're not trying to brush something under the rug. All right, so here we are. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and search for loads on Central Dispatch for this example, because I cannot give this demo without searching for loads on Central Dispatch. All right.
Exactly.
Nope, no problem. All right, cool. So here we go. So I'm going to do a city search of, I'm going to do Cleveland. Let's just say John is from Cleveland. All right. Now, I'm doing my central dispatch search, like I normally would. This is me looking for cars. I have never heard of Dispatch Monkey so far in this example. I'm looking for cars. It's Monday morning. I didn't find cars, or I was so sick of searching for cars, or I was so tired of monkeying around with this. There we go. There's Cleveland, Ohio. Thank you. So now I've got Cleveland, Ohio, and I'm going to do our regular, you know, I know where we go. I know where we like to go. So I'm just going to choose south, southeast. That's kind of our route. Cleveland to south, southeast. All right. And I'm going to do, so that I don't see buses and freight liners, I'm going to do car, pickup, SUV, van. Now, I guarantee at this point, if you're a brand new dispatcher and you've watched a couple of my car hauling dispatcher training series, you're already once again seeing, this is a good way to begin filtering searches. Now, I'm not a rocket scientist, but I do know that, I mean, as you and I have talked about even today, there's always little tips you can pick up about creating a better search. And what's amazing is, even with all the filters I'm going to do, I still got to sift through 200 search results manually, right?
Let's put another city there at the destination too, Jay.
At the destination?
Yeah, like choose the destination that you want.
Okay, you want me to choose a city, right?
Yeah, choose an origin city, 100 miles, and then the destination too.
Okay.
A city with 100 mile radius.
All right, sounds good. Then I know what I'm going to pick. I'm going to pick Atlanta. As difficult as it is, I know it has loads. All right, so I'm going to go Cleveland 100, Atlanta 100, okay?
And then you can just show them, you know, the filters there.
Okay, then I'm going to keep going. So I'm going to do, because it's my home city, I'm just going to do 10 days because I don't mind seeing the future. I am in the DeLorean. I'm going to do a 40-cent mile filter. I'm not going to do a minimum total pay. Although, really, I don't want any cars under... I'll say 250. All right. Somebody out there saying 500. That's okay. I'm going to show 500 search results because I want to show as many as possible. If Central Dispatch would let me do 10,000, I would pick 10,000. Right?
I wish.
I wish. But no. No, that's not going to happen, Jay. So, because otherwise what happens? It runs too slow, right? I'll tell you what.
Maybe that 25. Yeah, I think change it to 500 too.
So you know what's fun about this show? Since we're not gonna dodge elephants about Dispatch Monkey, let's go ahead and talk about some elephants about Central Dispatch. Can we do that?
Why not?
Can we all agree that that's at least fair, right? If we're gonna open it up, man, let's open it up. So why? Why won't Central Dispatch let you do more than 500 search results? What is the answer?
Good question, Jay.
I don't know. I really don't know. Okay.
Well, I can answer that question. I can try and answer that question and say that, you know, it's already difficult to even scroll through, like, even 50 search results. So imagine... going over 500 of them.
Hmm. There you go. Okay. Yeah, maybe that's what it is. Okay. So, by the way, how much does Central Dispatch pull in per month, Zimboy?
Well, considering that they have about, 14,000 members, you know, all that's about a dollar, what is it, $120 a month?
I think it's...
So you're looking at probably about $1.6 million a month.
And what is that a year again? It's like, it's over $15 million a year.
That's over $18 million a year.
And we're talking about car hauler monthly subscription gross revenue, correct?
Yeah, exactly.
$18 million.
You know, $18 million a year, and, you would think that some of the new technology and stuff like that, you know, Central Dispatch would actually kind of catch up on the technology part of it and be able to, you know, even have, users view really the whole platform the way that, Dispatch Monkey looks at it.
All right, so
increase the numbers too.
Hey, by the way, CarShipIO Stan just asked an awesome question. What's the point of having 100 plus search results unless you're a machine? Guess who's a machine now?
DispatchMonkey.com.
DispatchMonkey.com. All right, so let's go ahead and see what we get here. Come on. Come on, lucky sevens. All right, I got 56 search results. All right, so should I do the Control-C, Control-A, Control-V?
Exactly, yeah. So now you can go ahead and do your
so do
copy.
Control-A.
Control-A.
Control-C.
Control-A, if you're using a PC and then a MacBook, it's Command-A. So.
Command-A, okay. That's good. And I was saying, I think you should put that on this front page here. right? Put those instructions up here.
Yeah, we have those instructions there on our website, yes,
And then this should be a DeLorean. This car going up and down the ramp. Have a DeLorean with his doors going open. All right, I'm kidding. All right, so control A, control C is to copy. And now we're going to control V, paste it in the search box. All right, so we just took the bathtub of search results and dumped it in. Now, I have not gone through and manually, right? Nothing up my sleeve. I have not gone through manually to see what's in the search results.
Exactly. You don't need to do that anymore because you have dispatchmonkey.com. Dispatchmonkey.com does all the work for you.
So I'm going to pick John, my driver. I'm going to pick Cleveland. Right, Cleveland, Ohio, and it has an auto fill. And then I'm going to pick Atlanta, right?
Yes,
Okay. Now.
And you made it 100 mile radius,
That's right. All right, so here we go. Discover the best routes. Click. One Mississippi, two Mississippi. In 2 seconds. Now, what's very important is it starts off with the 500 miles radius around the origin. Which is why, if you look at this, and I'm going to control and zoom out on my map, you might look at that and say, GJ, I don't think I'm going to Detroit to pick up cars. So what's wrong with your monkey, right? And I'm going to say, well, let's just change the size of the radius on both ends to 100 miles. And recalculate.
Exactly. Yes, this is the road data that we have here, Jay. You can
see
that.
Okay, that's still within 100 miles.
Opens up 500 miles, yes.
So now, because it's still seeing stuff in Detroit that I don't want to go to, I'm going to click the only pick vehicles in the direction of my destination, right? So.
First of all, do 100 miles, 100 miles each,
Okay, and wait, but the thing is, I'm seeing Detroit because it is within that proximity. Now, I could close it down to 50 so I don't see Detroit.
Yes, exactly. So what you want to do now is first show the audience is that this is the pickup
for
the first route.
So, with respect to... Gosh, there's a lot of deadhead miles. The answer is because my radius was too big. Whatever I tell dispatchmonkey.com to do, it's going to do that. It's just going to keep crunching the data that I dumped in the bathtub. So, yes, the data that it is returning to me comes from the search I did, but I don't have to manually dig through those search results. Dispatch Monkey literally does all of the calculation that I would have had to manually do.
Exactly.
And I mean, there is, now let's talk about it. Can I book this route? Let's say I've got a four car. I got a Hyundai Accent, which as you were talking about, you've got your pictures here. So there's my, that could be my belly car. I could put a Highlander. Oh, and there's two vehicles. Interesting, so a broker's two vehicle load, Dispatch Monkey thought it was one vehicle. And that's okay. As we know, you know, we talked about this today, is that you are not waiting until the thing is absolutely super duper perfect to bring this to market. It's pretty good and you're constantly working on it. And you're going ahead and you're going live. You've already gone live. I mean, we're live right now. We're showing a product that, yeah, there's going to probably be things that can be updated. You were talking about different buttons on here that can be added. But before we go into other things like that, how am I doing on this search? 50 miles around Cleveland, 50 miles around Atlanta. This is actually a reasonable search that if I didn't have a lot more time, maybe I could just go ahead and book this, right?
Yes, actually, let's tighten it up, Jay. Let's do even a 20 mile. Let's see how far we can tighten the pickup and the drop off location.
That's a great idea, man. All right, so, and it's so fast. All right, so here we go. Now we're down to, it's got a two-car load.
Let's see what we get from 25 mile radius.
Changing the fields is still a heck of a lot easier than digging through the search results. And I just hit control, and I use my mouse wheel, and I zoom out. I look at the map. I can also click this box, and I can see it full screen.
And then let's explain those marks there, too, on the pickup there, so that our audiences can understand what that means. You know, the purple D and the 1 and the 2.
Okay, fair enough, right? I'm jumping. I'm so used to seeing it, I'm jumping around. All right, so the purple D is my pickup location city for the driver, right?
Exactly.
And the green one correlates to the blue one. Maybe you could keep the color the same to the first car that I would pick up.
Yeah, the best way to do it, I click on order of pickup.
Okay, I'm going to click on order of pickup. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
The order of pickup on top there, it will actually automatically zoom it in and out.
Cool. Okay.
And then do order of delivery, because dispatchmonkey.com actually tells you how you as a driver is going to pick up all the units that are assigned to you and how you're going to deliver them to.
And so
you see there when you click, so the purple D there always stands for the driver.
Right. The purple D is the driver. And it's interesting, too. That was another thing. When you first were talking to me, I've had a couple drivers that always asked me if I could look and figure out their order of pickups and order of deliveries and text it to them. I would no longer have to do that manual work because you created a share with driver button.
Exactly. Let's show that to our audience. Let's share that with them, and let's indicate that. See, let's say you have booked these two vehicles right here, Jay. You can take it from there.
All right. So if I share that with the driver, then I can go up here. I can click on trips, right?
Yes. Just click share with the driver.
And then I do get an email, but it's also saved inside of dispatchmonkey.com. Tells me the name of the driver, the number of the loads, tells me the date and time that I shared it, I guess. And then I click on the route.
Click on trips.
And there it is, man. And you know what's interesting is, I think you would say, Doc Brown getting in the DeLorean, this is just the beginning, Marty. I think this tool is awesome, which is another reason why, like, I see so much potential. I'm not worried about, like, it's not already booked and I'm not at home drinking champagne. I'm so rapidly seeing so many benefits. And I'm a dispatcher. That's the disclaimer here. I should not like this. I should think this is a problem or feel threatened or, you know, that this is going to replace me, but that's not true because there's plenty of work to do. I got to contact the broker. I need to negotiate. I need to book the load. I have several drivers. Maybe this tool will allow me to have more drivers. Right?
Exactly. And one thing, too, that I want to explain here, Jay, is that, you see, after you click share with driver.
Yeah.
That's all you have to do with dispatchmonkey.com to be able to send all your loads to the driver's app. And that's all you have to do. You don't have to save a PDF file from your computer and then double-click it and import it and stuff like that like you do on Super Dispatch and other, TMSs and stuff like that. This is all you do. Once you click share with the driver, that's it. It goes straight to the driver's app, and the only thing the driver has to do next is just to go pick up the vehicle. That's it.
Man, that's awesome. That is awesome. And what's interesting too is these contact broker buttons, this is the exact data that came from the central dispatch listing, which is another thing that I find very impressive about this program is the data integrity that it's all intact. You did a very clean scrubbing of the data.
Thank you, Jay.
It's really clean. This is awesome. So I know we're getting questions, and we're going to we're going to address some of those questions. But let's go ahead and let's do next. I think one of the next questions is, well, what if I have more data? Can this thing keep digging through larger amounts of data? I mean, I just did Cleveland to Atlanta on a rope, right? What happens if I open it up? And the answer is...
Yeah, well, actually, you can open it up, just do maybe 75 miles there so that they can see that it actually brings more cars within that area, yeah.
Right. Once I open up the circles, it'll see more cars, right. And I don't have pasting in the results. It remembers what I copied. Now, what's interesting is, it doesn't know... DispatchMonkey.com doesn't know what's been added to Central Dispatch in the last 10 minutes. So I'm going to back button on Central, which, by the way, is another one of my pet peeves, because if I have many drivers on the road, and I was telling you this earlier, if I do this search, Cleveland to Atlanta, then let's I'm going to demonstrate it. Let's do another search. Then I've got another guy. This is because this is what happens. I got another guy. He wants to know what's happening with Pennsylvania to Florida. Okay? So I got to do that. I get that phone call. Oh, believe me, dispatchers, there's plenty of work. All right? So I get my 9 car on the phone. What's going on Pennsylvania to Florida? And I do that search. Okay? And I'm looking. All right? Now I got to manually dig through his stuff. But not with Dispatch Monkey. I could create a new driver tab and let Dispatch Monkey dig through his stuff, right?
Exactly, yeah.
So I'm going to go ahead and, let's see here. I'm going to pick a driver. I'm going to do PA. I'm just going to do straight up Pennsylvania.
What kind of car hauler we got there?
This one's a 9 car.
It's a 9 car, okay.
And I put in 1 through 9 because... I didn't have time. I wasn't thinking. The phone's ringing. I got people barking for certificates. We've got an in-op that can't be located. There's plenty of work for the dispatcher. Not to worry. All right? So at least I can... my 9 car's like, so what do you see? Do you see anything? Okay, you're right, man. I see some stuff. But let me put you on hold because I got to go back to my 4 car. Yeah.
Put the specific city.
Let's do it.
Hey, Jay.
All right. So let's
put the specific city and the specific.
Let's do it. Let's say I'm gonna say he's within 50. Let's do 50 miles of Pittsburgh, and I know that he really does like Orlando. I know that he prefers Orlando. All right. So let's go ahead and just recalculate it. And what did I do wrong there? I know what it's. Oh, is it? It's not possible that it doesn't have.
Well, yeah.
Is it?
We
is
need
it?
To put the specific city and state. Remember? Yeah, so that we're specific to the radius.
Right. So what did I do wrong? I did this before. Is that I didn't do when I did my search? Okay, I did Pennsylvania to Florida, right? And I got 86 results. This is one of the mistakes that I made last week. Right? Because I see Pittsburgh, and there's got to be at least one Pittsburgh to Orlando in here. Right? Maybe?
Exactly.
I mean, there has to be. Although, you know what? I don't manually see one. There's a Harrisburg.
Just keep expanding your radius, babe. Okay. Put it maybe 200, so that we get something on Dispatch Monkey.
Yeah, maybe there's not. All right, so let's do Pittsburgh, PA. Oh, the chat line's going crazy. Oh, no, I'm looking at a different window. Okay, so let's do Pittsburgh to Orlando. I pasted it. Discover best routes. Okay, So let's do, I'm going to do 200 miles to 200 miles. Let's start with that, okay? And I'm going to recalculate. Now, it says no results. I'm doing something wrong. I have to be.
Okay, let's go back on central dispatch. Let's go back
dispatch. Oh, you know what? I didn't do the copy and paste right. Control A, Control C. I think I copied. I think I did the wrong one.
Probably, yeah. There you go.
I did.
There's something there.
And I did the wrong copy and paste. Okay. So, but before I forget, I want to get back to what I wanted to show. So we're seeing loads, and we'll come back to him. But if I go back to the four car and I hit the back button, I no longer have. I mean, I can click on the city search and find Cleveland to Atlanta, but it, I wish the screen, the old look, used to remember exactly what I was searching for that, for this window. And the new look doesn't have the same memory the old look had. Why? Where did that memory go? I don't understand it. And my point is that we're talking about elephants in the room of technology. I see some definite elephants in the room on Central Dispatch. And how much do they make a year again? Why do they... Right, what's the number?
A year? A month?
Either one. It doesn't even matter. It's so much.
A month is about $1.6 million, and in a year it's about $18 million, over $18 million.
So how come there's so many technological limitations if they're making that much money? Even Facebook continually updates their technology, and Mark Zuckerberg was in front of Congress today.
Yes, he was.
Okay. Alrighty. So let's go back to, I think we'll come back to the 10 car in a minute, but let's go back to the 4 car. I think one of the questions happening right now is, okay, but can it search regions? Like Stan said, does it work with a wide area search like a region search? Okay. All right. So, tell me what to do.
Okay. So now... what we want to do is let's show everybody like the region searches. That's what everybody seems to be asking about, the region searches.
Yeah.
Where we actually put the home state and stuff and show them how dispatchmonkey.com actually is an amazing tool, because you can actually then start moving within the state yourself.
All right, so let's do it. So... I said Cleveland. So, what are you going to say?
That's fine. So Cleveland is in Ohio. So just choose the whole state of Ohio.
All right. So I'm going to choose Ohio.
Yeah, let's keep it simple for him. So let's just choose Ohio and then choose another state that's close to Ohio. Let's use Ohio and Michigan there.
Ohio. Okay, so Ohio and Michigan for the pickups, right?
Yes,
And let's also do, can we do one more? Can I throw in Pennsylvania?
Yeah, we can throw Pennsylvania too there, huh?
All right. So I got my pickup. I got three states for pickup. Now let's... Okay.
So you have Ohio, Michigan, and Pennsylvania. Exactly,
Yeah, I
so
got
now
it.
You can choose where you want to go,
All right, so I'm going to say... I can choose a region. Let's do, here's the deal. The deal is, I know that I'm looking at probably Alabama, Georgia, the Carolinas.
Yeah, just put maybe three states, two states, so that we can demo it correctly. And, you know, the audiences are welcome to, you know, put as many states as they want.
Okay, so I got Ohio, Pennsylvania, Michigan, and again, I implore you to go to Dispatch. Go ahead and open a dispatchmonkey.com window right now. You can minimize the video on this. You don't have to see this. You can listen along and do this. And use dispatchmonkey.com for free so that tomorrow when you start searching for loads, just fire up dispatchmonkey.com. Don't lose all that time manually searching. Just let dispatchmonkey do it for you. All right, and this will prove to you right now in the demonstration that this does work. So we're going to do Ohio, Pennsylvania, Michigan on the pickup, and we're going to do Georgia, North Carolina, South Carolina on the delivery, okay?
Yep. And then let's do our filters now and make sure that we choose...
Car, pickup, SUV, van, right?
Yeah.
Okay. 0.4, 250. I'm not going to do a minimum pay. Let's see how, you know, because I'm not going to see that anyways. It'll all be thrown at the bottom. Dispatch Monkey brings the cream to the top, right?
Yeah.
This is Dispatch Monkey. Is dispatchmonkey.com is where gold bars float.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Okay. So I'm keeping the 10 days, the 0.4 minimum per vehicle pay, which should happen because I'm going south. Going north is the hard part. But all right. So 500 results, 1 hour newer, and lucky sevens. Let's pull the lever.
How many results did we get there?
I don't know. 358. So let's dig. So let's manually dig through 358 results. Who wants to? Anybody got some Kool-Aid ready? Let's do this thing.
Can you hear me, Jay?
Yeah, I can hear you, but I'm smothered by search results. Hang on.
Okay.
I'm digging through results. I'm somewhere in the hundreds. I didn't see much because I was going so fast. All right.
There we go.
What did
we get there?
358.
Oh, okay, cool.
Two of them are new, so people are still working. All right, so Control A, Control C.
Control A.
Right?
Yep. And then what we have there is our trailer. We can keep it between 3 and 5 car hauler so that it, you know, they can be able to see all the vehicles there.
Should I change the driver to a 5 car?
Yeah, change the driver to, say, like a 3 car hauler.
3 car?
Yeah, 3 car.
All right, so let's do, that would be me. All right, so I'm going to click on Dispatch Monkey. I'm going to select me. And now what do I want to do for pickup and delivery? Do I want to do cities?
Well, let's start with, remember we put Michigan, Ohio, and Pennsylvania. So let's start in Detroit. Let's say Detroit to Birmingham. Detroit to Birmingham.
No, we left out Alabama. Let's pick a Georgia or Carolina.
Okay, so we can do Detroit to Atlanta.
Atlanta, all right. Ready?
Yes, Atlanta, huh?
1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi. Still faster than Central Dispatch. Okay, so I hit Control and I can zoom out. But like you're saying, I can click order a pickup, right?
Yes, uh-huh.
And so,
order a pickup.
Or I can click it again. And so, For a first search result, let's go ahead and switch my screen here. For a first search result, I'd say this is looking pretty good. I mean, meaning I wouldn't book this yet because there's too many deadhead miles because my radius is too big. Right?
Exactly. So, yes. So, the way to use this tool now, Jay, go to your origination location down there, and you can tighten that up to 100 miles now. You see, this is the default here. It uses a 500-mile radius from the original location and 500 miles to the destination location, the radius.
Right. And this is really, I mean, we're talking version 1.0, right?
Exactly, yeah. And then if you type to like the origin, they're from Detroit and make it 100 miles, because nobody wants to drive 500 miles to go and pick up a vehicle, right?
Right.
But, yeah, so, you know.
But I can see that. So, I, like, just a manual look. Now that Dispatch Monkey has done all the calculation, I can see that, like, this Dodge Truck Ram 1500, this thing pays a buck a mile. This dually pays a buck 95 a mile. So maybe South Carolina, I really kind of want to pick, this is where I was telling you that, we were talking today. And I was telling you that what would be cool is if, for these three right here, if I could pick one to begin chasing this route. Because I like this anchor load, and I want to see more loads that are close to that area. Right?
Exactly. Yes, exactly.
So
if you like that, what is that, that Dodge? Is in Columbus, Ohio.
Yeah, the Columbus to Blacksburg. But I'll tell you what, since I'm really, well, let's see, that's the west side of Michigan.
You see, if you like any of those three cars there, Jay, you can just go up there and put that city. Remember what we did this up. Put that city up there.
That's right. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go with the Michigan to Georgia. I'm going to go with that. Even though the dually is a buck 95 a mile, I don't want to start my trip in Columbus. Okay? So I'm going to go ahead and put in Wayland, Michigan, and Bogart, Georgia. And in the future, you were saying I wouldn't have to type that in. I would just click on number 3. Right?
Exactly. And another thing, too, to let the audiences know, Jay, that you see those little numbers there in blue, 1, 2, 3?
Yes.
They actually signify the order of how you pick up these vehicles. You see in green there?
Yes. That's right.
And then when you click on order of delivery, it also does the same thing.
Okay. But since I'm route scouting, as I say, I'm going to hit recalculate, and now it's going to focus on me starting my trip in Wayland, Michigan. And now I already see different options. Oh, I'm going to hit control. I'm going to scroll out. And obviously that's too much deadheading, but let's see which one I like the best. I like, okay, so I got my Bogart. I'll tell you what, though, I'm into cars. I think I'm going to start looking at, I'm going to stay with Wayland, but I'm going to really head towards, let's see what happens if I head towards the Carolinas. So let's change Bogart to, let's change that to Savannah, make the circle smaller, let's see what happens. Okay, and now this Silverado showed up that I didn't see before. So,
You see what you did there, Jay, by clicking on the map? You really don't have to do that. Just click on order of delivery on top there.
Okay, order of delivery. I gotcha.
Right there. Then yeah.
Right. Right. I am, I'm a big picture kind of guy, so I keep zooming out. Oh, that's awesome, man. Dude, well, I'm in the DeLorean right now, for sure, because I am, here's what I know. This is why I'm excited about DispatchMonkey.com. And again, I said this to you today. Dude, next Tuesday, I'm going to be talking about something else. And the Tuesday after that, I'm going to be talking about something else. But I really do see something special here, and that's why I gave you two shows.
Thank you so much. We really appreciate that, Jay.
Absolutely. I mean, this is so interesting to me, because as a dispatcher searching loads every day, what I'm able to just do by changing fields, I had to dig through. How? I mean, that takes a long time to dig through. And if you're a new dispatcher with a new driver, or a veteran dispatcher with a new driver, I know the pain of digging through lists of cars and trying to have to figure out, I got to remember cities, cars, and I'm putting patterns together. You know, I'm turning the Rubik's Cube, and I'm pretty good at it. But this thing is way faster at calculating those formulas than I was. I mean, but I would go toe-to-toe with this. Meaning like, you know, like Casey Jones versus the hammer or whatever. That's what this is. There are there are dispatchers out there that are going to say, don't need it. And that's fine. But there are new car haulers out there that I guarantee, now that it's free, could absolutely use dispatchmonkey.com.
Exactly.
I mean, hands down.
It's a free tool now for all car haulers to take advantage of and you know, make sure they learn it, use it every day, you know, to get the best paying vehicles.
And you just, you know, even if it just keeps showing loads that I wasn't thinking about, but yeah, let's keep tightening the circles. I mean, I'm seeing something here, right? And Dispatch Monkey, even though I got 100 miles to 100 miles, it's still got 3 suggested routes.
So exactly. And you can tighten that too if you want. You can, hey, you know, say, let me see within 60 miles of where the driver is.
Yeah, let's tighten it. I just did 70. Okay, it's got 1 route with 2 cars. Okay.
There you go.
So I pushed it too far. Let's do 80-80. Let's see if I can get 1 route with 3 cars. Okay, I pushed it too far. Let's go. Man, 100 seemed to be my sweet spot there. And I also know, just like Central Dispatch has a search option, which is, what do they call that? Let's do the back button here and confuse the heck out of it, because it has no memory. Does it remember? Let's see. Let's see if it remembers Pennsylvania, Florida. Oh, it does. Awesome.
Yeah.
Okay. If I do 3 windows, I'm going to confuse the heck out of it. I know that. Because I have like 8 windows, and it doesn't know where I was. Shoot, man. Good luck with that. So, multi-city search, just like Central has multi-city search, you have the ability, since I only chose Ohio, Pennsylvania, Michigan, if I selected like, what? I could do like northeast to northeast, right? But I'm limited by Central Dispatch, aren't I?
Exactly.
Because if I really just wanted to make this easy, I just do, Ohio, and let's do northeast, midwest to, and it's 919, so I'm just jumping ahead. Let's do northeast, midwest to southeast, south, okay? And I'm going to do 500 because that's the maximum I can do. And
maybe even before you do that, Jay, we can show them a little more down there with that data you have there on Dispatch Monkey. If you want to go on dispatchmonkey.com.
Yeah.
And then we just move around more cities like this. We can move Savannah, the destination there. Since you chose Georgia, let's put that, say maybe it's Atlanta, Georgia up there, or even Macon.
Atlanta, Georgia. All right. And let's do Atlanta, Georgia. I got 90-90. And, I'm back to 10 routes. Yeah, because Atlanta has a lot more stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And it's interesting. It's over in Grand Rapids. Okay.
The whole idea is just for our audiences to be able to see and know that you can just change. If you've selected the state, you can actually just change the cities and stop and the mileage. You don't have to go back on Central Dispatch.
Right. Now, if I want to see brand new loads that were just posted, I would go back to, let's say I've been searching this for an hour. I might go back to Central Dispatch,
true,
scoop up the new fish, throw them in the bathtub, and then let Dispatch Monkey do its thing, right?
Exactly, yeah.
And we also know another criticism that you could raise is that the 3 vehicles suggested may or may not fit on the trailer. So that's another feature that needs to be updated.
Exactly. Yes.
Okay. All right.
Did you click up contact broker so that they can see how you contact the broker?
Yeah. So that's a good one. You just click contact broker, click it, and make go away. Click it. It brings up all the information. And then I could, in the future, the phone number might be clickable or something. I don't know where you're headed with this. Maybe you can click on websites. Maybe you can email. By the way, there's another one. Speaking about elephants in the room, I can click on the broker and I can send an email. Where's the email address though? Why are we still, does anybody use a fax machine? Who's using fax machines? Anybody?
I don't.
I haven't sent a fax in. I don't even remember when I sent a fax last. All right.
Now here, Jake, you can actually tell your audiences that go back to that contact broker there.
Contact broker, and then we're gonna. I see some great stuff in the chat. We're gonna go into the chat after this. Okay, click contact broker. Yeah. Okay.
And then you can see the broker's phone number, a reference ID number. You can copy it there too, and then go and paste it on, say, CarsArrive load board or RadioAuto transport load board, so that you can search and book it from there.
Right. Okay. Right. Oh man, and that's another thing. Tying in all the different load boards. I mean, there is so much room for further improvement and development. I mean, I wouldn't want your job, man. I mean, I think there's so much more that you can do with this. No thanks. That sounds like a lot of work, man. I mean, you have done so much work so far, but for version one, there are so many ways you can go. And I don't want to get you excited because I know you. You'll crank up the DeLorean and try to take me to Back to the Future 5. Right?
Yes.
All right, let's go into the chat line. Let's get into some of this stuff. Let's see here. Jay, does Dispatch Monkey work with MetroGistics and other load boards besides Central Dispatch? Zimboy.
Yes. All those load boards, they work on dispatchmonkey.com. But most of them realize that all these other load boards, they really deposit more on centraldispatch.com anyway, you see. So, and not too many drivers and transporters really go on these individual load boards. Most everyone goes to Central Dispatch because everyone dumps the loads there.
It's true. I mean, it's, and you'll know, I mean, like, okay, like Ready Auto, I think what they do, and anything I say about any of the other products are my user experiences. I believe that Ready Auto dumps on Central more than a couple times a day. So if you're smart and you're savvy and you remember to do this, you want to check Ready Auto like regularly, because you will find loads there that are not on Central Dispatch yet, which is the perfect time to bid for more money and get it. But if it's good and it's been dumped on Central Dispatch, do not spend the 10 minutes to bid. It will be gone before the 10 minutes are over. Right?
Exactly.
Yeah. So that's Ready Auto. So they dump on Central multiple times a day. And I think there's a total pattern to it. I've never clocked it. I don't know if MetroGistics does the same thing. I mean, their stuff is on Central. But to book it, you have to go to their site to book it. To book Ready Auto, you have to go to their site to book it. United Road, I haven't figured out. Sometimes there's loads on United Road, urautoloads.com, that aren't even on Central, and vice versa.
Well, yeah, and another thing, too, with most of these load boards, I'm sure everyone here has noticed that whenever they post a vehicle on Central Dispatch anyway, and you actually book it, like United Road is even the worst one of them, because they will stay there for hours and hours before they can even take it off. You understand? And a few of them would actually remove it almost instantly. Like ready auto transport will take maybe, you know, a few more minutes and stuff like that. And but United Road is really, really the bad one.
Okay. So Alexander, and what's the, oh, when cars arrive, you can search cars arrive and find loads that are not on central dispatch yet, like Ready Auto. That's why if you're savvy, you will check the top five load boards regularly. Top five load boards, central dispatch, Ready Auto, cars arrive, United Road, MetroGistics. I keep saying that. That is what I've determined since 2017. I don't know if that was true in 2016, but it was true in 2017. It's still true today.
Yeah,
okay.
The top ones. Remember, they used to be not before, but you know they were big too. But you know, MetroGistics got them.
But their load board was not that great. I mean, and as far as loads that you'll find. Central Dispatch, Ready Auto, Cars Arrive, United Road, MetroGistics. That, as far as volume, I'm not talking quality. I'm talking volume. Central Dispatch, Ready Auto, Cars Arrive, United Road, MetroGistics. I mean, that's the thing. If you're going to book loads, which is why they're pulling in 1.5 million on carrier monthly subscriptions, because they're up here.
Exactly.
Okay. All right. So capitalism works. All right. So now Alexander Collado says, okay, it won't work without city destination. True. You have to put in a city. Is that true? Do you have to put in a city? Because if you put in a state, what?
Well, you see, you have to put in the city where you are coming out of. Because, I mean, just... anybody who is moving from somewhere, going somewhere, you know, you have to start somewhere and you have to end somewhere. So you have to indicate where you're starting from and where you want to end up. And that's Dispatch Monkey then is going to help you find the loads in those criterias.
Which, by the way, we did not show the backhaul.
No, we did not show the backhaul yet, yes. So we can certainly do that because dispatchmonkey.com does actually show you and calculate a backhaul for you.
So we're gonna do that in a minute. Don't let me forget to do the backhaul, okay?
No problem.
All right. Let's see. What is the point? Okay, we read that one. Does it work today? Wide area search. We were working on that one. Does it work on the phone like an app? That's a great question. Answer.
The app is going to be we have an app already. It's going to be unveiled within the next couple of weeks.
Okay, so I mean we are, you know, we're dragging the skeletons out of the closet. So I got my phone here. I go to dispatchmonkey.com. I can see the site, right? And so it's in place, but it's not ready. Is that correct?
Yes. Uh huh.
Right.
Yes. It's not ready to unveil it yet, but
right.
it's existing, and you know we're just ironing out a few things and stuff, and that's exactly what this show is about here tonight. Jay, remember, so that
yes.
You know our audiences can let us know exactly too what it is that they want to see on the new app, because this. This is a technology company that is for car haulers, and you know, remember that too. I am a car hauler and a dispatcher, so I understand this very well.
And by the way, full disclosure: this is not an app. We are at a URL on the phone, so we're not pretending this is an app. We know that we're at a website in a browser on a mobile phone, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, we know that, so no problem. Okay. Let's see. Works in regions. Because there's no Orlando in the search results. Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah, and so, I mean, that's the thing. I'm still a noob, dude. I'm still a noob, right? I'm not a professional at using Dispatch Monkey, but that's okay. We're here to see what it's like to be a user. So this is, we're brainstorming together. That's part of the fun here. So, right? This is fun. Who's having fun? Anybody having fun? If you're having fun, hit the like
button. I am.
All right, I'm having fun. I really am. I love that. Man, I look forward to every Tuesday night spending time with the core, with the crew, talking about car hauling. And I mean, we talk about problems, but our goal, we all have the same goal, to make money and improve the industry, right?
Exactly.
Okay. All right, cool. All right, not yet doing region. Next version we'll do city to region. Sup. I'm late. That's okay, Brendan. I'm open. Welcome to the show, Brendan. I'm opening new calling business. Where can I get good dispatchers to get me loaded? All right, Alizik, man, welcome to the show if you're still here. If you need a dispatcher, send me an email, autotransportintel@gmail.com. I will get you hooked up. Thinking of doing Seattle to Sacramento. Mm-hmm. Cool, man. I like it. Equipment, Seattle. I know I pay through the roof coming in and out of there. Always talking about the route. That is a tough route. You need to put more emphasis on the map. Okay, CarShipIO Stan says, by the way, Stan, your feedback is very valuable because you know so much about car hauling technology. So keep it coming. It's welcome, and I look forward to having you on the show again at some point. So yeah, man, keep it coming. You need to put more emphasis on the map, the right side, and make the car results panel smaller. All right, so there is some graphic interface feedback for you from Stan at CarShipIO. Okay, Zimboy.
Yeah, thank you very much, Stan.
Cool. And Tony Beard says, I'm not sure what she's referring to, but welcome to the show, Tony. All right. Mike likes the tool. Thank you, Mike. Alizik, can you show me what they pay from Seattle to Sacramento and back? I smell a search coming up. Original tweeter, is there a limitation to which browser you can use? Zimboy, is there a limitation to which browser you can use?
Not at all. You can use any browser.
He says, on Edge, I keep getting an error that I'm not copying from Central Dispatch.
Which browser is that?
Microsoft Edge.
No, I've used that.
So, okay, so let's say somebody's having a specific issue. We talked about, you know, here you have an individual having an individual problem. Can they contact you?
Yes, uh-huh. They can contact us on contact@dispatchmonkey.com or right here on our site. You see, we have a little chat box there at the bottom, on the bottom right.
Okay. Right here.
Yes, on okay. The bottom right, we have a little
and
you can chat with us there.
Uh-huh. Same thing on the phone, right?
Yes.
All right, cool. So, all right, that's cool. Self-made uses fax. My apologies, self-made. Hey, this is cool too. Isn't a backhaul just another search flipping locations? Yes, Stan. I'm so glad you said that. Because a backhaul search should be simple, right? Can anybody show me the backhaul search button on Central Dispatch?
There isn't none that I know of, Jay.
Oh, come on, but it's so easy.
You would think that they would just put it right there in between the two search forms.
How much do you think it costs to program a backhaul search button? Anybody?
Well, if you're making over $18 million a year, I don't think it costs more than half of that.
So we also, in dragging elephants out of the closet, we decided we'd go ahead and have a little fun. You know, I don't mind if, you know, if somebody wants to come on the show and talk more about making products better, whatever it is, the Kaufman trailer, the orange height stick, the car hauling technology, the DOT safety inspection, I don't care what it is. If you want to talk about it and make it better, let's do that, right? I know people are doing that on Facebook. So I'm hoping to make YouTube added to that social media platform of making this stuff better. Because I started this channel because on YouTube, I don't see anywhere you can go to keep the discussion going to make this industry better. I couldn't find any channel. So I created Auto Transport Intel. That's the story. And if there is another channel to do this, please let me know. Because this is not a walled garden. I don't believe in that stuff. I've reached out to Hotshot Dave. I've reached out to Chico the Transporter. Who else do we have? Surge the Car Hauler. So, this is a network. This is an open forum. And this is an ecosystem. So if you got something to say, let's say it. All right, cool. So everyone started doing software. Nobody wants to drive. That's pretty funny. That's Gino, man. Thank you, Gino. It's true. Nah, it's not true. Somebody's driving. Because I have the pictures of a car hauler in the woods to prove it. Let's see here. That makes so much sense. $10. Okay, they're talking about money. Okay. Let's do a new search. Let's do a search for, who was that? Who asked Seattle to Sacramento? And what I like about this is we're also going to do the backhaul search, right?
Exactly, yes.
We can do that. So what we're going to do is, let's do...
Maybe you can, one of these days, try and get Central Dispatch on your show, Jay.
What? But Auto Transport Intel's not big enough for us to come on that puny little show, right?
Well, we talk about Central Dispatch here almost every Tuesday to where they,
it's such a small show and he's such a hack, you know, he's drinking Kool-Aid and, you know, he's an upstart, he's rebellious. This is unorthodox. He's talking about, did you hear that guy? He's talking about Back to the Future and turning apps into video games. Oh, I didn't tell you about that, did I? So I told, Zimboy, here you guys go. I told Zimboy about 7 or 8 hours ago that I think we should make Dispatch Monkey more like a video game.
Exactly. I think that'll be really cool. You know, it's already almost one because, you know, you got a lot of pictures flowing in and out there on the map.
That's right, because the first time I started dispatching, I felt like I was at a slot machine in Vegas. All right? So let's do slot machine games. There we go, slot machine games. Because searching for loads on Central Dispatch is a lot like playing slots. I mean, there's a similarity. But basically, once I choose my filters, I hit the spin button. And I'm hoping for gold bars and sevens. So why not make Dispatch Monkey, when I hit recalculate, 7, 7, 7, 7, gold bars.
Wow. That'd be cool, Jay.
That would be awesome. I think the user base would skyrocket when people found out at Mannheim's, some guy standing there on his phone, and he's searching, and he's got sevens scrolling, and he's like, oh, I just got a Honda Accord and a 1500 for $1 a mile. And the guy standing next to him is like, what are you doing? And he's like, I'm searching for cars.
Exactly.
What?
That'd be cool, dude.
What are you doing there, playing Candy Crush? Not exactly.
Nope.
I'm playing Auto Transport Crush. Yeah,
yeah,
dude.
Finding cars, finding loads.
So you guys heard it here first. This is a brand new idea. I don't know if Zimboy is going to do it or not. It's not my company. I don't work for him. But it was an idea that I had, and he likes the idea because he's a little off like me. And you know what? You got to be a little crazy to
spend. I mean, you know, that recalculate button, they can just be like the Wheel of Fortune. You know, and just
777. Oh, man. This show is kind of fun. Oh,
it
man.
It is, man.
It really is. This is fun. So, all right, let's go back to, we're going to do the search. Let's say you are thinking of doing Washington to Seattle. And, here's another one. New York to Virginia. That would be another one, another good one for the backhaul button. But,
yeah.
Okay, this is for Alizique. Okay. So we're going to do, let's just keep it, we know what we're doing. We're going to do, I'm visual, so I go in order of what I can picture in my head. I'm going to go Washington, like your engineer would start at A and stop at Z and click the states. But I'm not an engineer, I'm a visual, crazy, you know, slot machine games guy. So Washington, Oregon, California, okay?
Uh-huh.
I'm going to do the same for delivery.
Okay.
Because right now, and tell me if I'm wrong, but I'm just gathering my data to dump in the bathtub.
Exactly. So which states are you choosing there from your origin?
California, Oregon, Washington. California, Oregon, Washington.
Okay.
Because I'm going to start with... Oh, and I don't know what size car hauler he is. Let's just say 5 car.
Okay.
Okay. I'm going to leave out the minimum pay because I don't know what's going to happen. And I'm going to do all vehicles because I don't know. Maybe he's a flatbed. He's not a 5 car flatbed, but you know what I'm saying.
Uh-huh.
All right. I'm going to do this search. And I'm going to get hopefully less than 500 results. I think so. It's the West. They don't have as many cars. By the way, 1,700. All right. So let's do this. Let's back this up. Let's create some more filters so I don't get boats and heavy equipment and all that stuff. Car, SUV, van, and pickup. All right. And I know I'm not hauling stuff for a dime a mile, right? And I know that I want stuff that's ready in the next few days. And let's see how I get with that. Fair?
Yeah, we should. Yeah.
And then I'm going to start raising the minimum pay per vehicle. Because I'm not hauling stuff for $70.
Exactly.
Right. So let's get rid of that. Yeah, I'm not going to pick a car for $60. I'm not going to do all this work searching and pick a car for $60. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen. Nobody wants a $60 car. That's a different industry. All right. So
we don't work for peanuts. We don't work for peanuts.
We do not. We do not. So now I got 100. Okay. So I still got 1215. So what should I do? Let's do this. Let's just raise the minimum. I want to make some money here. I'm going
to
take.
You see the dollar per mile there at the bottom. See, 0.440, I think.
Yeah.
Let's raise that up to even like I just make it like 0.6.
Okay.
Eliminate quite a lot of cars.
Yeah. All right. Cool. 0.6, $200 minimum. Besides, what's the going rate from Seattle to Sacramento? It's probably what, a few hundred bucks? 400?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
All right, still got 673 because Central Dispatch won't let me go over 500, right?
Exactly, yep.
I mean, what are we to do, you know?
It would be really just easy to just pull all the data from Central Dispatch and just use it.
Well, after they watch this video, they're probably going to take away the 500. They're going to make it 100. That way, Dispatch Monkey can't use it anymore, right?
Well, it's still a lot of time. Jay to scroll through 100 loads just to be able to choose a route. Still, dispatchmonkey.com is the ultimate tool.
I'm gonna do this. I still think that 250 per car, I think 200 is low. Let's do 300. Because I really think Seattle to Sacramento, you're looking for cars that pay more than 300.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah, I think you are. So, and I will say this, kudos to Central Dispatch for some of those filters, right? I like to be a fair guy. I say something nasty, I say something wonderful. I just got to come up with more wonderful things to balance it out. That's okay, so I got it. I got 491. Control A. Control C. We got a winner. Okay. All right.
You see how long it takes for you to bring the results back?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Central Dispatch is the hard part. This part's easy. I'm going to go with, let's see here. I'm going to create, I don't know if I created a 5 car. Did I? I don't know.
I think you did. So we have, what, 491? Is that what it is there?
I'm just going to call this. But I can create as... How many drivers? Do you have a limitation on how many drivers I can create?
We didn't put a limitation.
All right. So I can create, like, 500 drivers.
Because you know, we figured some companies may have a whole... bigger fleets, you see what I'm saying?
Exactly. So, well, listen, man, you need to come up with more limitations. I'm very upset with you.
Like Central Dispatch,
man. Okay, all right. I think we've had too much fun. I think we need to calm down and be more respectful, okay?
Well, we like to respect Central Dispatch for giving us the,
listen,
you know, over the years.
Absolutely.
We've been able to feed our families off of Central Dispatch.
Yes.
So, I mean, you know, Central Dispatch...
Raise
you know,
a glass. That's right.
Give them a big pom-pom for, you know,
that's
being
right.
able to facilitate for us to be able to have a load board for car haulers.
But it's kind of like the movie theater that they just haven't fixed up. After a while, you don't really want to go to that movie theater anymore.
Yeah.
You know, it's kind of run down. They did a couple things. They put in, you know, they did the cotton candy about 10 years ago. And then, yeah, they did another snack bar like 5 years ago. But really since then, you know,
yeah.
there's gum on the seats. And, you know, it's just, you know, we're looking for something new. We're ready for something new. Gum on the seats. You like that gum on the seats? That was... Oh, man, that is ridiculous. I sound like I've been at a truck stop. All right, Seattle to Sacramento. 5 cars.
Exactly.
There it is, man. I mean, it's already... Dude, how many search results? 491. I didn't have to do anything but copy and paste.
Exactly.
That's awesome, man. Even if...
And then for the background, you just switch the cities and the state on top there. That's all.
Right. So I'm going to, because I'm a dispatcher, I don't close windows until I'm ready to call it a day.
Exactly.
All right. So, and here's what you do. Just like, now Priceline doesn't have this, but there was another travel site. There's a button in the middle that shows arrows, and you click it, and it switches delivery for pickup, pickup for delivery. And you're ready for that. You see what I'm saying? Let's see. So if you can see the screen, you'll see it in a second. This is where your switch pickup and delivery button goes. You see right here in between the pickup and delivery, you click it and it just switches.
Yes.
And
I'm
pretty sure if we could scrape together another million, we might be able to get one of those. All right. You've made your point. Ease up. All right, so this is looking pretty good. Seattle, I got, and it gave me one route when I did 100 to 100. And
okay.
That doesn't look bad. I mean, that's not that bad. for a vending machine, that's not bad, dude.
Not at all.
And, okay, so that was my Seattle to Sacramento. Let's go ahead and do Sacramento to Seattle. I like your auto-populating fields. It's pretty fast. Let's see if I get it. Lucky sevens! Zzz. I got it, man. I got a route. I got a backhaul. Somebody call Alizeek, man. Get him on the phone. Oh, he left?
There you go.
Ah, dang it. Another search down the drain. Let's see here. Maybe who knows? Oh, yeah?
And also, Jay, you can tell the audience is to see the gross revenue. It reduces as the route
Yeah, the gross revenue. I know, that is cool. Well, that's another thing about your the data, any data that exists on the central dispatch load board search results is kept in full integrity on your data dump. And I mean, the broker information is there. You're primed to start having dimensions, arrangement of vehicles on the trailer. I mean, there are so many things that can be automated. Literally, you could begin to show the trailer and where each car goes on the trailer. Because it's all,
yes, exactly.
It's all just math, dude.
Yes, exactly.
It's all just math, dude. Oh, man. Okay, what time are we at? Oh, my gosh, we're at 9:53. So, that's late, dude. It's time to wrap this up. Oh, my gosh, we're almost at a two-hour show. Oh, I can't believe it. This has been awesome. So,
That's what happens, Jay, when you're playing some computer games and slot machines.
Exactly, man.
You lose track of time.
Dude, what a mind job that would be if dudes were lined up at the port playing Slotomania auto transport search.
That'd be cool.
And here's the idea even further, is that what if you could compete? Oh, I was telling you this today. There should be a timer up at the top of the screen of how long it takes you to create a route for your driver. And you could compete on social media and have scoring systems, points, rankings, etc.
Exactly. Exactly. And remember, too, what I told you, that the dispatch platform is actually going to be really cool, because you won't be able, you're not going to do all the logging in from all different companies and all that stuff. You will just have one login, and you'll be able to see all the companies that you dispatch and all the drivers, too.
Oh,
so that,
yeah.
You know, keep opening up all this. So we're solving all that problem.
You'd have brokers like, you know, this broker moved this many loads on dispatchmonkey.com in the last 7 days, 30 days. Now, before I get too excited, okay, Stan has raised another interesting point. Let's drag it out. Let's bring it out in the middle of the driveway and shoot it. Jay, but 50% of those cars may not be available. Now, I'm thinking Stan is saying that because in the time it took me to create the search and dump the data and look at the cars, that by the time I got that done, those cars may not be available. And I got to tell you, I already know the answer. That happens in the time, that definitely happens in the time it takes me to dig through 491 search results.
Exactly. Tell me about that. Since I started using dispatchmonkey.com, I've actually gotten all the vehicles that I have copied and pasted on central dispatch. On dispatchmonkey.com.
That makes sense, because you're not spending so much time digging your own grave. Oh, man, I just came up with another one. Don't spend so much time digging your dispatch grave and get dispatchmonkey.com.
Exactly. Remember that, anyway, before you can even get a route on central dispatch, you have to keep clicking on MapQuest, VueRoute, one by one. That's very tedious, Jay.
Don't get me started about crappy maps. Oh, no. Why? Why use crappy maps?
Exactly.
Does anybody use crappy maps? Like, in between faxes? I don't get it, man. I don't know. I'm so confused. No wonder we're in the Stone Age. No wonder we're in the Stone Age. Oh, my gosh. Well, but you know what? And I guess it's like anything else. You know, when the Eagles go on their reunion tour and the cheap seats are $1,000 a seat, the Eagles do not care when they're counting million-dollar bills in the locker room at Shea Stadium what some dude in the cheap seats thinks, right? Who cares? Let me have my fun, right? Because you got so much money. Who cares? All right. I meant more towards going wild with that and do arrangements on the trailer. Oh, yeah, totally. There's so much room for... It is. It's mind-blowing how much room there is for these incredible mathematic... You know, and I made a video on this because I was so disappointed when I found out that auto-load logic isn't real. Oh, I was so disappointed. I don't know.
What happened to them?
All right, well, so I don't know. Somebody out there knows the story, but they don't exist, and I think they almost existed. Like, I mean, there were these... The goal... Uh-oh. Now I got my video going. I mean, my audio going. Let's X that. The goal of auto load logic was to, my understanding, was to help you understand that when you book loads, it helped you load your trailer so that you didn't have to think about it, right? That you could take data and dispatch, and maybe they were also a load board. I don't know, man, because again, this is like, it's kind of like finding lost scrolls in the desert, right? The civilization's no longer there, but these scrolls are cool, right? So, like, this great idea, but what happened? I don't know, but it was a pretty good idea. You should watch all of the auto load logic scrolls. I mean, information.
Yep.
It was a great idea, and it doesn't exist, and I found that so strange, because I literally thought it was like an actual company, and there wasn't anybody to tell me otherwise. And that was became another understanding of auto transport intel, is to, you know, this is not an expose, but rather, isn't it important to know that this dream is no longer available?
Wow.
I think that's pretty important.
Yeah, I mean, it's very expensive to develop these applications here, Jay. It's very, very expensive, and
yeah,
you have to keep up with, you know. I mean, Super Dispatch. Super Dispatch, you know, I've been using Super Dispatch for over 2.5 years. And when we first started using Super Dispatch, it was very fast. But man, now Super Dispatch is very, very slow, to a point where, especially when you use trips, I mean, it takes like over 10 seconds just to, you know, bring data and stuff, and it crashes too. And it's becoming to be more of an inconvenient TMS to use. Super Dispatch is becoming more of an inconvenient app to use, because half the time it's not working and it's slow, the dashboard is slow. So it's really, really, you know, not convenient anymore like it used to over 2 years ago, because they've gotten so many people now. You know, they're kind of going the same way as Central Dispatch. When you have so many people, you keep getting the money and you don't do improvements, you know, it's very, very difficult for the users anymore.
Right. Well, and you know, and I will drag this elephant out real quick. I told you that I'm not going to talk about that. So, you know,
not a problem.
That's for you. That's for you to say. So, and you
well,
know,
I,
maybe
I'm a user of a Super Dispatch, and you know, it's getting to be very slow. So, you know, I think I have the right to say that as a user.
Okay. Well, as a user, that's the thing is, as a user of a product, you have the right to give feedback and let the company know what you think and talk to other users. In fact, that's one of the interesting things about social media is it's opened the floodgates of opinion. I mean, oh my gosh, right? Companies can read things about their customers that they could never find out before. So it's wild.
Ultimately, Jay, we are the car haulers, and there's not too many softwares out there that are actually, you know, have been engineered by a car hauler who has been there from the bottom all the way to the top, who sees the problems on the road. That's exactly what DispatchMonkey.com is. It is a tool that car haulers are going to build. And car haulers are going to say how they want this thing to move forward, and it's for them, and it's free.
And so that's really, you know what, that's an awesome ending point, is that DispatchMonkey.com, and that's why I've had you on this show 2 weeks in a row, is it's an exciting new tool. I do believe it has true benefit. I believe it has a very unique offering that I haven't seen in any other software yet. If somebody's got a software that does this, I have not seen it. I don't know about it. And I welcome to find out about other products that might do this or offer other aspects of car hauling technology. And ultimately, you want to hear from new users, from non-users, from people that just reject the idea altogether. You are open to hear what people think, right?
Exactly. And listen, I am open, Jay. I'm open.
That's
and this
awesome.
Is for car haulers, and car haulers are going to build DispatchMonkey.com.
That's cool, man. That is cool, man. That's really, in today's world, that's how we want products to be built, is for the users to help the creators create the product that they truly want and need, not a product
exactly.
that they don't need that some creator thought was probably a good idea.
Exactly. And, you know, believe it or not, you know, engineer is also here on the show tonight, and he's listening in, and he hears all the concerns and the questions and what people want to see on the app, and we are going to take all these considerations here, Jay,
cool.
and implement them. See, we don't want to just listen and have people just catch whatever suggestions and stuff. We want to implement all these suggestions, and, you know, within the next month or so, people are going to start seeing all these things that we're talking about, you see, because it's for car haulers.
And I want to say this, too, is that, in similarity, in kind, Auto Transport Intel is a YouTube channel for car haulers. I encourage you to also give me feedback about this show, about what you'd like to see on future shows, questions, discussions, comments. It's all welcome below in the comments. And before I finish up, I request your likes, your shares, your comments, click the notification bell, and subscribe, reverse order, click subscribe, then the notification bell, because we would like to see, ultimately, there are some things sitting comfortably at the top, and we would like to rise up and challenge what would be conventional wisdom that seems to be in need of improvement and repair.
Exactly.
All right. Cool, man. I want to thank you for coming on the show again, man. It's really been fun, and we will keep in touch. I expect to see you in the live chat on some future shows.
Exactly.
Not every week. It's not mandatory or required, but I'm seeing people in the live chat that have been on previous shows, and I like to see the core keep growing. So listen, man, thank you so much for coming on the show. Thank you so much for all of the time that you've given me and the audience and the car hauling industry and its future. So I guess it's time to pack up, get back in the DeLorean, and head back to the laboratory, Doc Brown.
Thank you so much, Jay and Auto Transport Intel, for hosting DispatchMarket.com tonight. And it's a free application for car haulers. And I implore all car haulers to try it out and have fun with it, and send us your suggestions too. Our email is contact@dispatchmarket.com. contact@dispatchmarket.com. And we have a chat window, too, there on the bottom right-hand corner. Send us a message, and we'll answer all your questions. Thank you so much, Jay.
All right, man. Thank you so much. You have a good night, okay?
Thank you, sir.
All right, take care.
Good night to your audiences, too. Bye.
All right, see you. Bye. Oh, man, that was awesome. I had no idea that we would run for 2 hours tonight. I did not think that, but I mean, there is so much to talk about, so I'm not exactly surprised. So, well, it is that time. I think I've gone through all of the things that I wanted to talk about. Dispatchmonkey.com. There is, you know, there's a lot they can add to the site as far as instructional information, and he's going to do that, and he welcomes all of the comments, criticisms, and input that you're able to provide, so keep it coming. And there's going to be some interesting things as the heavyweights enter the ring, to see what happens, because, I mean, we dragged out some, you know, elephants in the room tonight, and we talked about it. And that's not what every show's about, but, you know, when in need, when appropriate. We didn't say anything we didn't need to say. We're not picking on anybody, but we are talking about, you know, it's interesting. With ELDs, people are hammering hours of service because it's finally time to get to the meat of the problem and fix it. And that has got to happen in other areas such as load boards, or brokering, or what carriers are doing wrong. I mean, there are a lot of areas for improvement, and Auto Transport Intel is dedicated to talking about the ecosystem of car hauling. It's a big industry. There's a lot of misconceptions. There's a lot of room for knowledge, and that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to infotain, entertain, and inform. And hopefully you have enjoyed sticking around, being glad that you put in the 2 hours, the hour, the half hour, the 45 minutes, the 5 minutes, whatever you gave me tonight. I really appreciate it. And by the way, I want to thank, I had a super chat when I came in when I came into the live stream earlier today. Somebody gave me a super chat. I don't know who it was. There was a name I didn't recognize, and I didn't jot it down, and I don't see it now, but I really want to thank you all for whether you like, man, the likes help the show, the comments really help the show, rising in the YouTube rankings. I mean, you can't search car hauling now without finding Auto Transport Intel. Some of that I did, but some of that you did, and I really want to thank you for doing that. So thanks for staying with me on a Tuesday night. I love this show. I love talking to you guys, and I'm feeling it. So I'll be back next Tuesday night at 8 o'clock. We're going to talk about the 5 reasons car haulers go out of business. So please join the show, jump in the live chat, say hello. I'm cranking up that car hauler. I want to thank you guys, and you have a good night. You take care. Oh, and I don't have the... Woo! What?